Today we are going to be talking about Spring Data JPA, and that is very important because it's like moving into a new section of this tutorial on Spring Boot in 2019. Before we talk about Spring Data JPA, let me give you an architecture of what actually a JPA repository is. I'll explain these times very easily. So let me set this to the presentation. All right, so now, JPA stands for Java Persistence API. So it means that if you want to save data to a database, or if you want to persist data so that you could be able to use this data at a different time in your application. In the previous lessons we've done, we actually had coded some items or some records inside our application. That means that if you shut down this application and start it again, this data does not persist. So JPA provides a method for you to persist data. Now there are two ways it could be. It could be in-memory database. It could also be external database like Oracle database or MS SQL or MySQL database. So whatever you use to store data in the database, that is what JPA handles. Now let's talk about a repository. Now this architecture explains it all, what we've been doing. Before now, we don't have this repository layer. So when a user makes a request, how it flows is when a user makes a HTTP request in a browser, it hits the controller because this controller have mappings called the request mappings that captures the URL, a URL pattern, and calls a particular method from the business service. Now, if there is no data access needed, then you don't have anything to do with the repository. But if you have to access data, then you need a repository. Now, the challenge is in normal traditional database application, you need to write maybe stored procedure, or you write queries and things like that, and that is very tasking, sometimes difficult to do and prone to error. But now when we have a repository, you don't have to worry about writing queries, writing stored procedures, even creating the tables itself. The tables will be created automatically for you using Spring Data JPA. So that is the good thing about repository. It provides even the methods for get, put, update, and delete. All these methods are provided automatically for you. It looks like magic. It looks like something unbelievable, but that is how it is. So basically, if you come up to this place, build your business service, create your classes, immediately you create your classes and add the right annotation, these classes automatically, they map to records in the database. So this database, again, they are created on the fly. You don't have to create a database. So that is why JPA repository in Spring Boot is very, very powerful. So what we simply need to do is to create the student class, and then we add the annotations and do the configuration. Immediately, database will be created in the data store for us. So let's see how it works. I'm going to end this presentation, and let's go to see how it works. So I'm simply going to close this file. So now we are simply going to make it easy. And again, take note that we are doing procedure-based lessons. So all the procedures are also here. I'm reading and following this procedure written here, which you have. I provide the link for you in the description box in this video. Also, remember to subscribe, because if you subscribe, you kind of motivate me to make these lessons. You kind of encourage me. And also, you get notified when I make new lessons, and kind of you also have questions you can ask me. You have challenges, I can help you solve them if you leave a comment for me in the comment box. So click on the box, the red button that says subscribe if you've not subscribed, so that you get notified and updated. So these are what we are going to cover. Overview of Spring Data JPA. I've explained it for you using the PowerPoint presentation. If you want, you can go ahead to read this overview. So what we are going to do, we are going to create a student table, student name, ID, and department. So we are just going to use three fields in this student table. we are going to use Apache DB in-memory database. So what it means is that this database does not actually live in an external server, but it is an in-memory database that is saved in our class path. So in connecting to external database, we are going to do that in subsequent lessons. Then we are going to use Spring Data JPA to select, insert, update, and delete record from this table. And actually, this table will be created automatically for us by Spring Data JPA. That is really very easy and very interesting. So it's simple steps, as you can see, it's not much. So we are going to just do it right now. The first thing we need to do is to add the dependencies that is going to handle the data assets. So open the pom.xml file and let's add the dependencies. So I'm going to scroll down to the dependencies section. Okay, so I'm going to move this upwards. Okay, so you can see we have two dependencies here. Let me hide my taskbar so I'm going to automatically hide taskbar. Okay, so you can see that we have two dependencies here. We can see the dependencies section. So we are going to add one more dependency that handles the JPA. So I'm going to, let me make some room here as well. Okay, let's shift this one. Okay, fine. So there is a dependency for all the, this is Spring Boot Data, Spring Boot Data Starter JPA. So simply add it to your pom.xml, copy and paste it in the dependency section. So let me arrange it a little so it makes some sense. All right, the next thing I'm going to do is to add another dependency for the Apache DB in-memory database. So these are the two dependencies we need to add for us to be able to use Spring Data JPA. All right, so add those dependencies in there, okay? So go ahead to save. If you save, it rebuilds the workspace. Okay, fine. So let's go ahead to quickly create the student class. I'm going to create this quickly. And I want to create it and place it inside another package. So just go to new and create a new class. And I'm going to put it in com.kindsandthegenius. .social. This time .students. So a new package I'm creating. So the name of the class is students. Okay, so I'm going to just finish. So that is the first step. We've created the student class, as you can see. The next thing is to generate the constructor. Generate the constructor, then generate the getters and setters. For then, instead of typing out everything, let me just copy this and paste so that we will not waste precious time. So these are the three items: student ID, first name and last name, student name and department. So now I'm going to actually generate the constructor. So right click to generate the constructor, right click source and say generate constructor using fields. And I'm going to select all, select it, and I'm going to say generate. Okay, make some room. Now the next thing is to generate getters and setters. So right click and say source and say generate getters and setters, and then select everything and just say generate. Okay. So we've generated getters and setters, and we are through with this our class, the student class. So now what next are we going to do? Add the controller class, right? So this is very easy. So simply right click on the package, say new, and we are going to call it student controller. So again, remember you need to annotate this class with at rest controller. Okay, so Control Shift O to add the imports. Control Shift O. Okay, so let's see. Rest, okay, so address controller. So let's see, adds. Okay, so this is what we have. Okay, so you have imported from here, fine. So that's all about this for now. So the next thing we are going to do are the business service. Again, that is another class. So simply right click on the same package and say new class, and the name is what? Student service. Okay. Again, these are the procedures. So in case you miss something, you can just follow it. Again, you annotate it with what? With the add service annotation. Alright, so yeah, what's happening? So it's just telling us, okay, I'm just going to save. Fine. Okay, I'm going to come back here and import from here. Okay, so basically that is what we have. So at this point we have completed the first part. The next part now we are going to add the Spring JPA repository. Alright. So I'd like to thank you for viewing. Remember to subscribe, like this video, share it, and leave some encouraging comment for me. And also, if you have some questions, feel free to ask me.